once again, pool fans, and welcome to the Simonis Aramuth Arena for the 2019 International Nine Ball Open. Thank you. Thank you so kindly. Once again, we're here at the Sheraton Norfolk Waterside Hotel, our host venue, and we also have, once again, the best in the business, Diamond Billiard Products table here, the official table of the International Nine Ball Open. Well, we're in the middle match of the morning or daytime session here on day number two. We've got great action for you coming up right now. Someone you're very familiar with and someone you don't know yet, but you will be very familiar with in not too distant future. So let me introduce them to you right now. From the Philippines, this gentleman is a two-time Derby City nine-ball champion among a long, long list of accomplishments. He's sponsored by Clutch Shot Billiards Apparel. We know him as Robo Cop. Please welcome Dennis Accu-Stats. His opponent. First time in the United States. First tournament in the United States. From Chinese Taipei. Sponsored by Fury, 21 years old, known as the last co-warrior brother, because yes, he is a co-brother, he's number three. There won't be any more, don't worry about it, but let's welcome Ko Ping Han. All right, gentlemen, please go ahead and lag for the break if you would. Shot clock operator is John Baker, and at this time I'd like to send it upstairs to the A-team, and that means Mark Wilson and five-time Hall of Famer Danny Diliberto. Take it away up there, guys.
Elite nine ball action's on the way with Dennis ORCOLLO versus the youngest co-brother, Ko Ping Han. My name is Mark Wilson, and here with me is my longtime partner, Danny Diliberto. Danny, bring us up to speed.
Well, I never saw Ko Ping Han play, but I certainly have seen Ocala. He's a tough horse, always, any game.
Number four here on the tournament power rankings versus number 72 for Ko Ping Han. We know he can play. Started playing when he was 13. Won his first national championship when he was 14. He then gave it up for a couple years, emphasized darts. He took it back up and cites both of his brothers as his role models.
Good role models.
Ken Schumann was kind of funny in his opening. He says, don't worry about it. This is the last of the Ko brothers. Well, Dennis broke successfully, made a ball, but does not have much of a shot on the two, a very thin cut. He may have to attack the three ball with the cue ball here. It doesn't look like he can play position very easily. So he might try to dislodge the three by bumping it with the cue ball.
Yeah, but he's got enough room to fall in the same pocket he's shooting the two. Well, he dislodged it all right.
Very good shot.
Very good.
Look, world class, yeah. Yeah, trying to be cute and then roll that ball over there into that little gap. It's so tough at that speed, and then you're facing a tough shot to start the match. So he chose to go with a little more power, just let the cue ball go over there. Great billiard play.
And because he made the right decision, he got rewarded. That's how it works in this game.
Very nice open layout here to begin the match. This is a race to 11, all ball fouls. Nine balls racked on the spot.
Well, he got a good angle here.
Needs to kill the cue ball. Did so handily. A little bit of inside English now, soft speed. Very routine now after that first shot, that opening shot. This is what world-class pool looks like. One inning nine ball. You make one good shot, get control of the table, and then you stay in line throughout. 1-0, Dennis ORCOLLO. Nothing like winning the leg, breaking, and running out to get some momentum on your side.
Get you started.
Right. The other guy's lost the leg, and now he has a shot. Dennis has got a little feel for the table. He's made a great shot. A lot of things heading his way early on.
Well, this is the second day of the tournament. Who did ORCOLLO beat so far? Or is this his first match?
I don't know.
Oh, you usually know, Mark.
Well, I'd have to look. I got it on my phone.
You don't have to.
I could look it up.
Well, I was thinking.
I guess I should, really. To be fair, I do have it on my phone. Let's go over here. Oh, he beat another Taiwan player. Thank you, Lasman. Now, there's somebody that's in tune. Why do I not have it here, though? Well, I don't have it on my phone. But nevertheless, he beat another Chinese Taipei player. Oh, he beat Liu, L-I-U. 1 ball found the target. We're playing a 3-point rule. Success. Not the easiest shot on the three, but I'm sure he's glad to have this kind of a shot. Looks like he can still handle the cue ball well enough. The 4 ball would pass the 8 if he fell on it pretty nicely. The 8 only partially obstructs the corner pocket. But it's such a thin cut into the corner, I don't know that he can draw to get to that side. So he may have to play short side position.
The position is obstructed too.
Yeah, and now that we have the overhead, it looks like
he could do it.
It looks like he has to bring the cue ball over here and back over here is going to be the shot. Low left English. Pretty smooth. Oh, he really got into it. I don't think he meant to thread it between the 6 and the 5. I think he just got into it that well.
But it works.
Yeah, a bit better than he thought. Rewarded for a great stroke.
Got to kill the ball here. Oh, he don't want to be this far away, is he? Oh, he got pretty good. One rail to the 6.
You see how freely he's moving around the table. He's got a little bounce in his step. You can kind of tell. Sometimes Dennis gets in that mode. He'll even go into one-stroke mode. Uh-oh. He forgot to dig into that one.
He snookered himself.
Yeah. He had so much draw he got between the 5 and 6, or 4 and 6, and then now he let up on the draw. Well, he's going to try to kick it into the side or maybe cross side.
He hit it anyway.
Hit the right hemisphere of the ball.
I think he snookered him.
And the 6 landed on the rail, and it's just an inch or so out of the pocket, so this is a very thin cut with a jump shot. He may not even play a jump shot here.
No, I think you got to kick it this one.
Or Massey, which just looks like,
he is jumping. Kick.
No, he's jumping.
Well, the cue ball's going to fly everywhere.
Pretty smoothly struck, well hit.
He hit it very well. He's unfortunate it didn't go in.
Well, Dennis got to use the jump shot, but he has a far more makeable shot.
Good shot. Good result.
Mm-hmm. hit that little rough.
Right. It won't go later on in the week. Table wears a little.
He just cinched it. Didn't bother to play a position. Just going to accept the shot into the side.
Ooh. Wow.
Yeah, it's swallowed.
Well, anyway, back to what you just said. Buddy Hall had a good saying, don't play position when you already got it. And that's what he did.
Yeah. 2-0 is our score. Dennis Accu-Stats in front. For years, Danny and I were informed that Dennis was the best Filipino player out there, and we would broadcast his match and seldom ever see that type of a performance out of him. But then, over the last 5 years, we've kind of come to the terms that maybe he is the best.
At the time you're talking, he challenged any American player, give him the 7. You remember that?
Yes, I do. Yeah. He's a very confident guy. I like Dennis. I admire him.
Yeah. Well, you know how you get confidence? By winning all the time.
Yeah.
Good money player.
Look at breaking from his fingertips. You see his elbow canted off to the side a little bit. That's a typical.
Yeah, he's got the ball. Pocket down in the side pocket.
Oh, and he's...
Went right in.
Okay, the 8-ball broke the plane of the head string, so consequently it constitutes a legitimate break. They have a 3-point rule. 3 balls must cross the head string, or at least touch the head string. Every ball that you pocket, 1 less ball has to cross the head string. If you pocket 2 balls on the break, there is no requirement for anything to go across the head string.
Look at the stroke he laid down there.
Yeah, he pounded that into the heart of the pocket. Drifted the cue ball 2 feet. Perfect position on the 3.
It's going to go 4 and play the 4 in the other right-hand pocket. Nicely done. You really don't have to do much here. Make the ball. 5 to the 6 is automatic.
Watch Dennis play. He plays nonstop, and he practices like a fiend. Jay Helford says he stays at his house, and he'll go to bed at midnight or later. Dennis is playing. He'll get up at 7 or 8 in the morning, and Dennis is back up and hitting balls.
Yeah, that's really something. That's special stuff. Really is, because I played. No way I would do that.
Yeah. But no doubt we would have been better players had we. This will be a second break and run out for Dennis. And our score now is 3-0. For many people that don't know the Dennis Accu-Stats story, his grandpa was a fisherman, and it's my understanding that he watched his grandpa lose all the family money playing pool.
And he went out in the sea and drowned, I think.
Later on, they had a tragedy, but nevertheless, Dennis vowed to regain the family fortune through pool and practiced and practiced and practiced, and it's now superseded what his expectations were at that time. A lot of people ask me why are so many great Filipino players, and the deal is that there's not much opportunity over there. This happens to be one of them, and so they every city block in Manila has a pool room, and they're all full at all times. People are very serious about the sport, and the government sponsors some of the sport.
Yeah, Filipino to me are special. They helped us win the war, and they have good athletes. You know, Manny Pacquiao is a great fighter.
Yeah, good point.
Yeah, I just think they're great athletes. I always say this about Alex. He's such a competitor that I think he could have been a fighter.
Well, they have a lot of heart. They come from kind of a hard scrapple background, yet they're always cheerful. They all are singing karaoke and laughing, and yet don't have much, you know. And right. Here in the land of plenty, we
that's
complain.
That's why they're great players, to necessity. Look at that hit. Where are you going?
Wow, perfect. Make that hit like that. Speed. Use the six ball to stop the cue ball. Many years ago, I know you were there, Danny. We were at the bicycle club in L.A., and
yeah,
we had a couple tournaments there.
Right.
Manny Pacquiao was there. Efren introduced me to him and told me that someday this guy's going to be a great champion. And this is before he'd won anything. And I'm like, well, maybe, you know, I'm sure Efren wouldn't. But sure enough, Manny Pacquiao.
Well, I got an opinion about that. He shouldn't keep fighting, Manny Pacquiao. He got knocked unconscious for like a half hour. He should have never fought again, especially he's not broke. He's got plenty of money. He don't need to do this, but, you know, you get involved with a sport, and it's tough to let go.
Yeah. You don't think Paul McCartney needs money, do you? And yet he still tours and does a three-hour show.
Yeah, but he's
show.
Not getting punched.
That's true.
He don't have to make a ball either.
He's closing in on 80 years old, though. Look at this. A third break and run out here. Looks like Dennis is trying to win this tournament.
Well, he's a contender in every one of them. But tough field here.
Well, we saw Kopin Han lose the lag, and then we saw him make a great attempt at a jump shot. And other than that, we really don't know a whole lot about him.
He hasn't shot yet.
Yeah, there was a great attempt that he made, too. And Dennis made a mistake, but I really couldn't pin any kind of a mistake on Kopin Han. But that's what happens when you play in the big leagues. Sometimes you get shut out for a good while without getting much of a chance.
And it's that kind of sport.
Well, it tests your mental toughness. We find out who you really are. And if you come here hoping to go through here unscathed and get a shot almost every rack,
you're not.
You come to the wrong place. Yeah. Not up in here.
But we got players here that are evolving all the time. Kazakis is playing great.
Oh, fantastic.
He ran 9-2 games.
And then we just watched him win here against Danny Olson, and he looked pretty sharp in that, too. So.
Yeah,
you couldn't pick a winner for this thing, although I must say that our defending champion put on a great performance here on center court yesterday to start our festivities. And Jason Shaw playing fantastic, too.
Well, he always does.
Filler
different
played.
Kind of playing.
Yeah, Filler played here last night and did quite well.
He won, too. He's another contender. Shaw's a contender. Chang looks like the favorite right now, if there's such a thing.
You know, I didn't mention it, but I should. The nine ball does count on the break. Additionally, when you watch the guys break, they do the cut break on the head ball because the nine's being racked on the spot in an effort to drop the one ball into the side. Many of them are proficient at it. But additionally, because the two ball is racked in the very back of the rack, they're cutting it just a little bit more to get the two ball to end up by the side pocket, and that's their objective. And you'll see many of these players playing position on the two in the side. Now, this is our first real look at Copenhagen. Pretty nice open layout here.
Yeah, that subject, Moscone played, and He played exhibitions and ran hundreds every time, and someone asked him, how did your opponent play? He says, I don't know. I never saw him play. Of course, Moscone, one of the greatest straight pool players ever.
I missed. I was too young for his competitive days, but I did see his exhibition four times. All four of them, he said, now I'm going to run 100 balls for you, after he did some trick shots. Three times he did it on the first try, and the other time he did it on the second try. I'm like, holy cow. You know, it was amazing. You just say, okay, I'm going to run 100. Yep, that's what happened.
Not easy feat.
No, if you do it once, you can consider yourself a life master.
Did you ever run 100, Mark?
Yes, I did.
I shouldn't ask that. I should have guessed that you did.
No, you should know. I tell you every day. No, I'll tell you what I am proud of, though. I have a very tight 5x10 at home, and I did run a 109 on that
table. Oh, that's great.
Yeah, that was. That was. My next best was in the 80s, and I mean, I played a lot of straight pool on that table, too. You probably played on the table. Now that I think about it, it used to be in St. Petersburg, Florida.
Yeah, I did play there a bit.
A 5x10?
We had one in Miami, a 5x10.
Nice out there. Nice to come up there, 4-0 yeah. Behind, and make a nice clearance of the balls that are all open.
And he showed the people he could play.
Never got in trouble. All good angles. Throughout my life, I lost a lot of matches, so I don't mean this in a bragging way, but one time I played Irving Crane, and he was pretty old. He had a stroke and walked with a limp, you might remember, and he flew into Madison, Wisconsin, and I was the young kid there that was getting a little bit better and played him a game. And, oh, my goodness, I played my best pool I ever played. I ran a 30, a 40, a 30, and safe in between, not leaving open frames. I got so far ahead, I thought I should maybe give him a shot because people came. No, really.
Yeah, the people came to see him.
But then I thought I'll never maybe get the chance to play him. I ended up, I beat him. And then he was a little bit upset. He was a classy guy, and he wanted to play me again that night, but he didn't because the editor of the newspaper had the opportunity. And he came in that night, I'll never forget it. He had fire in his eyes, and he played and ran 186 balls. And just to show me that he has forgotten more about straight pool. And it was kind of one of these things that was unfair. I played a good game.
He didn't really get a chance. Well, I always said he was the best straight pool player.
Well, anyway, he made a couple break shots with no break shots out there, you know, where he just had to ram the ball around, and just it was amazing, and he just refused to miss. This was a non-compliant break. It's why he pocketed the ball. So,
and the end of his career was kind of sad because I played him a few times, and he got out of line on the break shot, and he picked the cue ball up and put it in line. I said, Irv, what are you doing? He says, I'm just hitting him around.
A good shot there. So the non-compliant break costs Copenhagen a game. Leaves Dennis a routine 9-ball. Negating the good run out that Copenhagen made. That might have been in Rockford, Illinois, where that happened, because I was there when he did something similar to that.
Yeah, he did it a few times.
And I really respect him. And so, anyway, that night he came back in there and ran 186, and he'd had a stroke, and but he was just refused to miss to show you. And it just so happens my all-time high run is the same as what he did that night, 186. But the real high run is John Schmidt, 626. To me, that's just amazing. Nick Farmer,
oh, it
too.
Is.
Yeah.
No doubt about it.
Yeah, some people want to criticize it, but if you impress Nick Farmer enough that he says, holy moly, that's unbelievable that he did that. That's the only validation that I would need. Eight-time world champion and Hall of Fame member. Great straight pool player himself. Well, here we go. 5-1 is our score. ORCOLLO cruising along, breaking off his fingertips. You just don't see that very often. I did see it yesterday with Bergman, too.
Yeah, Bergman's the one who beat John Schmidt.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, good point. That was our opening match yesterday.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of great plays so far, and it's not over.
Well, it's just opening day. It's amazing how many good matchups there are. All the outer tables, you look around, you recognize the names at every table.
He's shooting this? Not making it, though.
I think he had the cover, you know, the idea that there was some cover there, maybe.
Well, he didn't use the cover.
He didn't get it.
But ORCOLLO doesn't have an easy start here. He's got a long shot on the one, even though it goes to the two pretty easily, but you got to make the one. No problem there.
And see how he didn't try to overdo anything there. That was just cinch it, roll it, let it come across two rails. Don't try to get close. It makes that ball play too tough. Great decision.
He's got the right angle to go to the three.
Look at that hit.
Look at that. That was nothing.
two tremendous shots in a row. Now he's got a little bit of a tough position play. Easy by comparison to the last two shots, but still not that easy.
Not at all.
In reality.
The eight is blocking the path of the four. So what do you do here, Mark?
Yeah, it looks like from the overhead, looks like you have to go forward with left English. And he's looking if he wants to go all the way around. I don't know if we can get the overhead. If we do, looks like he can go all the way down two or three rails. He'd like to come over there where he's
at. And he just looked at the billiard, too.
And that might be what he does, because that's the most conservative route to for sure get a shot. You won't be hooked. And then it also plays a bit easier if that's where you anticipate getting, as opposed to if you end up inadvertently getting there. Well, now he's back to going forward, it looks like. No?
He's going back to miscuing.
I got
to
tell you something. I would love to get a replay of that shot, because he was uncertain about the outcome of the ball, and that backswing got so quick. Here we got the replay. Watch how quick this backswing is. And you see, and then the tip abruptly went to the side. He was unhappy with that shot to begin with.
Well, he didn't have something easy to get to.
Yeah.
And it showed in his stroke. Very rare does he miscue.
Yeah, and then all of us, once we miscue, we look at the tip, but it actually was our stroke 90% of the time.
Okay, we're going to see what Koping does.
Looks like he's going across table there.
Yeah, the ball goes cushions in the corner. Good speed here.
Man,
he fell on it. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Now, could he make it without hitting the eight?
I don't think.
So what do you do here? You draw one rail?
I don't think that either. I think you can follow and just lightly rub the eight, and just because the five is pretty playable, just bounce the cue ball off the end rail. I'd probably rub the eight a little bit.
Looks like he's drawing the ball. He wants to get straight in on the five, of course. He's going to take the long shot.
And use the eight to slow the cue ball down.
Yeah, but this is no bargain.
Oh, I love it. Looks good, very shot. Comfortable. Stayed so still and solid on that stroke delivery. He's clearly not in fear of playing Dennis ORCOLLO.
Or the tournament.
Right, or the tournament. But I guess when you play in his household, you probably would get pretty comfortable playing elite level players. cruised up there for the perfect angle, get down table.
Perfect is right.
You see how, see his ball speed and see how his cueing action's real smooth. He, this guy's super confident.
Well, I bet all of them have the fundamentals down perfectly. I mean, all of the Taipei players.
Very nice. So, Han takes advantage of that.
He's not intimidated at all.
Not at all. And he has to feel good. If I was him, I would feel good about my circumstance because he lost the lag. ORCOLLO broke and ran. Then ORCOLLO should have broken and ran a second time, but made a position there and got lucky. Left him a super tough jump. He hit it really well, quality stroke, barely hung it up, lost that game. But then ORCOLLO broke and ran two more after that. So now he's actually, he's performing at a high level. He just hadn't had many chances yet. Then Copenhagen broke and had a non-legitimate break and left a 2-9 combo. So that's, Dennis got his games, three break and runouts. And then from the jump shot and then the fact that he made a non-compliant break. So he really hadn't made any mistakes and he's playing well, scored two games. He's right in the match.
You're right. He's not out of it.
Well, three games at this level, especially when you see that he's cueing well.
Especially when you're only at five, the total.
Right.
You're still not out of it.
I mean, you're confident. When you're playing well, the score is immaterial. It's just a matter of, because you can win from anywhere if you can play like that. Okay, see how the two balls drifting up to the side pocket? This is where the players are trying to get. It's that two ball. Skylar Woodward last year kind of pioneered that aspect of trying to control that back ball. And it served him well. He went through four or five of the top players here and beat them about like 66 to 28 or something at one point. But it was largely because he was breaking, running so many racks because he was getting that two ball to filter up by the side pocket after pocketing the one on the break. Push out circumstance here.
Well, you got to give this back. Can't shoot this. No rewards if you make it.
I know. He's looking at the 2-7 combination, but afraid that Dennis will shoot this and make it.
You got to give it back. Don't you think so?
Yeah, I don't think that has enough reward, but I think he's afraid of being embarrassed if Dennis runs out from here after he gives it back. Very smart.
Oh, good.
Very smart.
You scratched. No, you didn't. And look, he hit the two, opened it up a little, but there's still no shot on the two, but there's no shot on the one. So it was a very good choice. You know, instead of giving it back, he decided to play safe, which and turned out pretty good.
Dennis might have played this shot, too. That didn't work out the way Dennis wanted.
No, he gave him a shot.
Well, a defensive type shot, but that's the point, is that he wanted to try to maintain control of the table and the cue ball. Missed its mark by quite a bit.
Well, does the one go off the ball?
No, I think he's going to back cut the one and just let the cue ball glide off the six and bring it down table and try to filter the one back to the center of the head rail there. Oh, boy.
Yeah, no rewards making the ball, so he's better off what he did here.
Tremendous
Dennis
shot.
Has a kick.
Tremendous shot.
But look at the way the balls are laying.
Yeah. Yeah. Even if you get ball in hand, it's not going to be a routine run out.
Good hit.
The speed.
And
who kicks with that speed?
He's the Filipinos do.
World champions do, yeah. But Dennis knows if he hits it, it's not likely he's selling out because of the 2-7. Three's not that easy. But man, that couldn't have worked out any better. Both players executing just perfectly. Looks like he was playing safe there. Because just the look on his face. Now Dennis has a chance to attack the two ball with this shot.
Yes, he's going that direction.
Takes a really good hit, though. You got to hit the pocket super pure.
He hit it.
Look at that shot. Look at that shot. Tremendous.
Got a bank.
Small target from that angle.
Well, it looked like if he could bank it and not get the cue ball to fly around.
What a great replay, too. Thank you. That was good. Real subtle, tough shot. We've seen Dennis make two billiard shots of that nature, just that way. In the opening rack, he cut a two ball.
Look at he that made billiard the billiard.
Shot. Yeah.
Where are you going, two ball?
Remember in the opening rack when he broke and made the two ball, and I said he needs to come over and chip the three out. Remember how well he executed that billiard? And then this one here, because the cue ball was up a little higher than one, you got to really be playing a lot of pool to gauge
well,
that.
Well, does the two pass? I don't think it does.
No.
And I think it's dangerous playing the combination, although the six is sitting pretty good. I think he's playing the six, Mark.
No. I don't
you
know if
don't
we have a chance
so?
To get the overhead, but if we do, this is one possibility. He may try to stiffen this up, the two ball, and send it back over here. Now, it takes a really good hit to do that and then have it filter down here, and then that way he can stun the cue ball down here. That's one choice. The other thing, he can thin across the two and bank it back and forth and just try to get the cue ball down here under cover. Oh, he was playing the six.
Yeah, I thought that was one of the options, but tough rack. We said it a little while ago, you couldn't get out with ball in hand.
Yeah.
The way they were sitting.
I guess if he makes the six, he figures to run out the rack is the reason he chose to gamble there. And the safety that I drew is quite difficult as well. So if you're going to shoot a hard shot, maybe go down shooting offense.
I think who you're playing helps decide what you do. Oh, he got good on the three. Got a good chance to get out here. Good shot.
Yeah, the balls are not rattling in. This kid is not intimidated one iota. In each of these shots, the cue ball's gone right where he intended it to go.
Well, don't forget, he's got a lot of brothers that play and play well. And he probably doesn't want to hear them say, you should have done this, you should have, right? Would they do that?
This guy's a good player from playing with him. I don't think he's worried about that. He's just a good player. He is no joke. Definitely belongs in this field. Big run out there. 3-5 is our score. Flawless execution by Han. He gave up pool for a couple years and emphasized darts, he said. Now, imagine that. Imagine that. He said he was going
to
quit pool
imagine.
Altogether. Yeah. Maybe it's because there was opportunity. I don't know what possessed him. And then now he's kind of refound his passion for pool. He's only 21 years old.
So he's going to get better.
he stated that his goal is to be top 10. Top 10 in the world is his goal, and he uses his brothers as role models. There's our Q-Tech TPA stats. Ko is ahead, 917, 911 on the TPA.
Good.
That tells it all right there. He hasn't had many opportunities, but he's made the most of them. Pretty cool. Dennis has made the preponderance of the balls, 41-22. Want to send a shout out to our good friend, Great White Band guitarist Mark Kendall, listening in. Glad to have you alongside, Mark.
Yeah, so I'll say hello to my friends in Buffalo at the Classic Q, Dave and Rick.
And see how that cue ball, all the players are letting the cue ball drift down low, is because it brings that two ball right up there by the side pocket. This is the, does not look one bit easy. Dennis will probably glide it in effortlessly, but the position of the two is not that easy. The two's not just hanging. That's why he had to go with power.
Oh, look at that shot.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah.
And he fell on the two all right.
He hit the pocket so pure and clean. Dennis comes over, scope out the five, make sure that goes.
Slow down. He's okay. Well, we already decided that the five goes, right?
Well, Dennis looked at it. I guess we'll find out if he decided it goes. It's hard to tell from my vantage point.
Yeah, I think he missed the ball.
Yeah, I could see he overcut that to begin with. Okay.
Well, according to what he was thinking, the five definitely goes.
And if it doesn't, he could still come around, either try to dislodge it or get it back into the same side the three ball will go in. If he only has part of a pocket, you really want to get pretty close and pretty straight on that five ball.
You know, if he can win this game, he's only one behind.
And has made far fewer mistakes than Dennis has, which he hasn't made very many, but I don't really feel like Hans made any mistakes.
The board, he made two mistakes. Dennis made four.
But Pat is, he's tougher grader than me. Pat called that jump shot a miss. I mean, come on. It was super tough. I'm a little bit more player-friendly grader. Look at that. Nice high left, trying to work the cue ball closer. He did not get real close.
Yeah, he would like to be straighter, too.
Yep, this can be a little bit treacherous here. Well, he's triple checking his line. This is the exact type of shot that you're uncertain about that will cause your stroke to get abrupt or quick. So we'll see what level of commitment he has here with his stroke. Well, there you go. And the report, Big Co looks on from the adjacent outer practice tables.
And he hit that ball on the full side, so you know it had plenty of room.
Great point. Yep.
Uh-oh. Yeah, it looked like he missed it from the beginning.
Did. Looked like his body shimmied just a little bit. He went through such a nice series of balls there, and that's the first stroke that would be a little bit iffy that we saw.
He really didn't come close. Well, this is a tough shot with the bridge.
Yeah. Good form with the bridge here as Dennis has got his head down by his cue and the cue very level.
Got to hit the paint here.
Hit it good.
Well, he's got to shoot this in the side, I believe. Automatic position.
All right, Dennis is happy to escape that rack because it was going to be 5-4, but Han had all the momentum because he'd played the better pool to that point in the match.
He missed the pretty easy shot.
That was his first unforced error of the match. Dennis ORCOLLO going to head to the bathroom here, so we have a short player timeout. 6-3 is our score. ORCOLLO breaking now. This is a race to 11. Two balls on the very back.
Well, he missed the side pocket with the one.
The two ball hit the point going by the side pocket. That's why it didn't end up near the other side pocket. On comes to the table after a dry break.
Well, he's got a shot on the one straight in the side. Not an easy rack here. This will be a good run out if he did it.
Looking at playing the one in the far corner pocket.
That would Why would he do that?
Well,
the cue ball going?
Well, he can dislodge the six over here doing it. But I think he's rethought that. I think he's going to play the one on the side.
Of course. Now he's looking at the corner again. But if you shoot it in the corner, where's the cue ball going?
Well, that time he measured up not in the corner. He was looking at the line that the cue ball would have to the two if he stopped the cue ball here on the one. Now he's back to kind of thinking about that. Does not have to play offense at all. Could play safe from here, too. Looks like he's going to try to follow forward with left English. That makes this shot missable. They have to power up a little bit. Yeah, didn't quite get where he wanted to go.
Does the two pass the four? And look like the way he played position, it does.
I don't think he wanted to be here because it's so awkward. You got to power up. The four is an obstruction. At least visually, it impairs you. And then you got to power up to get the cue ball back down table. And you might be right in that scratch zone, too. Now he's going high. Looks like he might even be using left. Yeah.
Yeah, he missed.
That was pretty complex.
It was a tough layout anyway.
Yeah. Well, Pat's a tough grader. I'm not usually, but anyway, I have to give him an unforced error on that shot. Now, Dennis has been very effective on these shots that are makeable, but certainly missable. He has had no trouble whatsoever with these. Good speed. Wrestled it into the pocket. Now this three lodged up against the side. That makes position play quite a bit more of a tenuous circumstance.
The shot is not easy, but he made that.
Boy, he did too. Beautiful.
Well, look at the seven in the way. You got to use the bridge. Is seven going to be in the way of the bridge? Looks that way. I think we're playing foul on all balls, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So he can't touch the seven with the bridge. That would be a foul. Tough layout here.
This shot would go a long ways to solving it if he could get it.
Yeah, he snookered. It was a tough layout to fall on the ball. He is snookered, dead snookered. And a tough hit.
Well, this looks to be, yeah, absolutely right. At seven, this, I don't know. We got the overhead, so I'll go ahead and use it. But it looks like he needs to go in here two cushions and down like this to make a hit.
I don't think he's got that kind of angle to go in that target. Well, he hit it. Did he get a rail? Yes, he did.
Great shot.
Very good.
Great billiard shot there.
And he didn't leave anything.
Able to use enough pace that he got separation, and then they lodged themselves in such a way that it was not even easy to return a safety. Elevating over the eight. This is just tough on every level.
No.
Oh, he overcut it too. He said, please don't double kiss it. No, it did.
Oh, look at this.
If it just cleanly gets by there, he leaves it tough. Instead, he left a very makeable shot. And what a nice hit.
Six packs past the eight.
The overcut on the five ball by Han, that's missing it on the pro side. It's hard to overcut it. Most everyone beats it straight into the rail, the end rail hitting it too fat.
Tough position here.
I think Dennis declared his extension. Said something. He didn't ask for the cue ball to be cleaned. I thought he said something like he wanted to think about it. No? He overcooked it a little bit there. Got in there pretty deep.
Well, I think it passes the eight, doesn't it?
Yep. Yeah, it looks like he may be three rails around here.
Gets to the seven inside.
Well, the problem is that cue ball, that if he thins the six in, looks like the cue ball might be on pass to the seven. He may nick the seven. You hate to introduce side spin here on a thin back cut like this, but he did it.
Yeah, but high is going to make it go a little longer, and that's what happened.
Now he fell just a little flat on this. Going to be tough to get close to the eight, so he's just going to have to work the cue ball back to the center of the table and cut the eight in.
Yeah.
Oh, he tried to draw all the way down.
And he did it.
Wow, what a shot.
Look at that. He's
what
got
a shot that was,
angle.
Yeah.
It was.
Now, this was a far from routine run out here.
Yeah.
What he started with. Good shooting there. Every shot was tough until he got to the nine ball. ORCOLLO 7 on 3. Dennis is changing sides of the table he's breaking from now, still on his fingertips. That means the two ball's going to the other side pocket now, I think. Yep. Didn't make the one. Here you see the two filtering up to the side pocket. The one gets covered. Dennis is not happy. This is a pretty interesting shot. If I can get the overhead real quick. I don't think he'll push out. If we had the overhead, I would show you. But it's a two-rail kick in behind the one and just filter the cue ball out to the outside of the eight. Super soft.
Yeah, you got to hit this soft.
So this, no, he's going to push out. I think Han's going to play it then.
This is a test. That's why he did that. Gave it back.
All right.
Ocolo's going to do a light kick, like you said.
Ultra light. You almost can't hit it too soft. And
might,
even if you foul, you don't saw a lot of times.
Snooker him, too.
Two rails is better than one.
Oh, he got it, too. Look at this.
Oh, great shot.
He snookered him. He hit the rail.
I'm really surprised that Han passed that back. That was a powerful shot. Here's a replay. Very good.
Tremendous.
Yep. Now it's real hard to defend from here. Oh, he thinks he can nick the edge. Okay.
Oh, I don't know. That's a tough shot. And the ball is frozen, isn't it?
Well, he knows. I mean, the cue ball's going to get to the rail anyway. Yeah, great shot.
It is. And he snookered it.
Wow. Wow. Well, now Dennis is in the predicament. Okay, but that's why you can take a foul there. You can risk it at that speed because you don't lose the game instantly. You're not going to be in a whole lot better place when you come back to the table, but you didn't sell out. You know, these great replays we're getting, they come from Predator Cues. They've sponsored us here. Man, what an addition this has been this week because we're getting some great replays.
The replays are knowledgeable.
Educational.
Educational,
yeah.
Right?
Very good.
We want the people out there to learn. Well, he's got a choice of where to go.
He's setting up to go one rail in behind the four.
Yeah. Got a chance to do it without selling out.
He might be going behind the nine here the way he's got it set up. Off the long rail. Yep. Oh, just a little harder than he really wanted. Now it allows Dennis that same two rail kick we started with. This will be the super light two rail kick. Good shot.
Another good
now,
shot.
Now Han's got that same thin.
Right.
Now we're back to, can you get behind the six again with this shot? This time it's a little easier to play the edge of the one.
Yeah, he has more edge to hit.
But it's still going to be perfect speed, and if you slightly hit a hint thicker or thinner, your speed's off. That's a pretty unforgiving shot. Good speed.
Yeah.
Wow. I mean, this is great. Now we're right back where we started. This is where Dennis fouled last time. What a great series this has been. This is world-class pool.
Now he's
great
got
exchange.
The other edge.
But I just say, what a great safety exchange here.
It is, and it's not over. Of course, the public really doesn't like this kind of thing, but they should to learn, see what's going on with the game. It's not about just making balls.
This has been fantastic. Series of beards. Hope some of my players at Lindenwood are observing right now. Look at that light hit.
There we go again.
And now it's not laying right for the two-rail kick. He may have to try to play it, but it's not really laying in the same fashion that they had been.
Well, he's got to play it. What are you going to do? You're not going to hit it hard.
You might go super soft one rail. No, two rails. Okay. No, great
there
shot.
We are again.
Yeah. That same two-rail kick has come up three times in this exchange.
Yeah, but now it's changed. Doesn't have an easy shot here.
As a point, okay. Do you remember when Dennis pushed out to this shot and Han passed it back? I bet he's learned now that he will not be passing that back, because it's happened to him three times where he's been in a terrible predicament from giving it away.
Yeah, we used the word experience again. And that's something you get right after you needed it.
In that life, the lesson comes after the test. Super soft. Try to land square on it.
Yeah. I think he left the cut now.
Boy. Yeah.
It doesn't have
might.
A pocket.
It may or may not. We'll find out if Dennis goes after it. It goes by there.
You got to get the cue ball out of the way quick. You're going to foul it. Good hit.
Yeah, he was playing safe all the way.
He got him, too. He left the edge again in the six. He's going to do the same thing. Cut it and try to go behind the six.
Looks like he thinks he has enough of it to bank the one on the side and try to bring the cue ball around.
Yeah, if he does that, he's going to be far away from the two.
Well, he went and looked at playing the two ball underneath the six back over here to play the two in the far corner. Of course, that means you got to make the bank for that to be any good. No, safety.
Oh, he left the hit.
Well, this kid's got all the shots, too, so.
This might be a world record safety off the one.
Like Dennis is looking at trying to just drag the cue ball back underneath the six here. No, he hit it way thin. I can't fault him on that. It was not an easy shot to play.
The ball banks.
Yeah, Han's earned the opportunity now. He's won the safety battle. He gets first crack at the one to do something. He does not have to play offense. He can play defense still.
Well, he shot at it. He was ready to shoot the two in the side. He got pretty good at that.
Yeah, he did.
Now this is my perpendicular long shot. Bank it straight back with a little reverse.
I think Dennis is trying to get the cue ball over there behind the three and the eight simultaneously.
Yeah, that sits with that same shot. That's where he's going. Bank it long rail right to where he's standing. Got him with the three and the eight. A lot of good safety play here. Well, I think he's got a pretty good kick.
He's going for the jump cue.
I only like to jump if you're shooting to make a ball. If you're not, you're better off kicking. This is not going to be good. Not going to get the best of this.
And Danny was right.
You're not shooting to make the ball, the jump is no good. You sold out finally. But it's not that this is a bargain. Well, he's going to make it look like a bargain.
Yeah, that's the thing. He makes these balls look like they're meant to just go into the pocket effortlessly.
Well, he's going to play the three in the side, maybe.
Another confident stroke there.
Yeah, and he got real good on it. Still a lot of work to do here. Good, he's got the right angle to go to the six.
Yes, he must have got straight.
He is a little straight.
Okay, he smiles. He's thinking, doggone, just a hint of an angle is all I need.
Well, I think if there's no angle, you got to bank it.
Well, he can cut it in.
Yeah, that's what he's doing. Cue ball's going to fly around a little.
Into the nine, I think.
No, I think he'll miss the nine.
Oh, okay. Yeah, if he can get around it, then it'll be great. He can just go soft speed. Yeah, you're right. Oh,
perfect.
Boy.
Look at this.
Well, this for sure was the most enjoyable rack of the set so far. There was a lot that happened in this rack. Old experienced head prevailed. 8-3 is our score, Dennis ORCOLLO.
He worked for that one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that game should have been worth two or three games.
Well, in diving, they use degree of difficulty.
Right.
That's what that was.
Or gymnastics, maybe. I don't know. Yeah. Do they? I don't know. It's a judge sport, anyway. But that was a lot harder game to win than some of them are.
And this is a long tournament. You get a few games like this, you might get tired. Right? That's tiring.
Oh, yeah. It takes complete focus, and then you got to execute.
Look at Dennis. Well, looks like he's taking a nap.
Just look in the field right now. Show me somebody that's overweight. When you look out on the adjacent tables.
I like that.
Right? They're all fit because you can't hold up for a week. Well, you have no chance. You'll be eliminated.
That's what was wrong with Mizorak. The end of the tournament, he couldn't play a bunch of matches because he weighed 400.
Well, Dennis made the one on the side. Here comes the two up to the side. Can he just get past it?
Oh, he hit the point.
I don't know if he can cut that or not.
Oh, I think so. He could.
Here on the overhead, looks like it'd be extreme. So.
Yeah, but he's got it.
All right. Well. If he does have it, he's going
to
hit the seven or the four. I don't think he can get around the seven.
Well, if he can hit the seven full, that'll hold the ball for the three.
No.
But let's see what happens. You know, this is what's great about pool. There's never the same two layouts, right?
No, right, right. Yeah, I don't think he can cut this, sir. I don't think it's worth it if he can. I think he's trying to decide how he's going to play this. He hates playing it because the safety's super hard here.
If there is one.
Well, yeah, exactly. I mean, if that's how hard it is, so you have to play something that's iffy.
I think shooting it.
Banking across corner?
No, in the side. I think he's cutting it.
I think he's banking across corner if he's playing it.
Oh, you're right. You're right, Mark. Did all right with it.
No, he did not.
No, I mean, I'm thinking of poor Co.
Oh, yeah, for Co, yeah. He's yeah. Quite delighted.
Yeah, I wouldn't draw the ball here. Now I would. Good shot.
Yeah, and this kid, he's not making bad shot selections. So, you know, you can see he knows what he's doing. His angle down the table is so much better than ours. So I'm not going to second guess his shot selection, especially after he got to where he's at now. Smoothly moves the cue ball down close to the four.
Well, I don't think he can go forward. I think he has to draw the ball past the six. Oh, he might not even have to hit the nine. Good shot.
Just gonna stun out to the middle of the table here. Not much to it. Just good execution.
Did he get enough ankle? Might have just enough.
No, he
got to hit it hard.
Not real hard. Well, he's making the decision whether he wants to roll ahead and play short side, or he can stun it over.
I knew with speed he would get more glance.
And he had to hit it pretty hard to even get that, so he must have been very straight. But a nice rack there, his fourth win. He trails in the match 8-4.
Timeout.
And we're going to have a player timeout now by Co. Okay, everybody, the balls are racked and we are back. 13th rack. Han will be breaking rack number 13. Balls. This is a compliant break. One ball checks up by the side pocket. This is a nice rack to run here.
Well, he's got a good chance to get out here. He's not really out of the match yet. This one puts him within three. Looks like nothing gonna stop him here. Got the right angle to go to the two.
Love the way his tip gets through the cue ball. You can see this is a high-level player because it almost like it stays on the cue ball an extra millisecond. That's kind of the hallmark of great players.
Tell me this. Do they, all the players from Taipei, do they use the same kind of cue? I don't know if that's a good question.
I'll say yes.
Well, you can make a living making cues for the...
Yeah.
There's so many of them.
Tip repairs in Chinese Taipei has to be a good business to be in.
Well, he got to the corner. No problems here. Just stop. Perfect. Good speed here.
Just back from his break. Opens up with a nice break and run out. 8-5 is our score. You know, all three co-brothers are interesting. The older one, Big Co, crazy hair,
yeah.
Two-time world champion, fearless competitor. Then you got Little Co, and he's all of 90 pounds and slides his feet on every step and then just kind of swishes into the shot and then the cue ball comes around. You're thinking, how does it get there? Knows every shot. And then now here's...
And he ran second last year.
Right, and then we have Kohan. And he's completely composed, together, polo shirt, button down. I mean, he's much more orthodox-looking technique than Little Co. Wonder if they have a table at their house. You know, it'd be probably be hard to get on there, yeah.
Yeah, but then they would fight about who's going to play now.
Well, that's probably, to get table time, it's probably challenge the table. Maybe that's why they're so good. One ball, did not find the side. It's a compliant break. I don't think it's a... He didn't make anything, so it's a dry break. 8-5 is our score. Dennis says that referee Ken Schumann can leave the Eltsville racking template on the table.
Yeah, it would be pretty tough to get it out of there without moving the balls.
Right. Just a hint short with his speed, but great effort. Moved the one ball 9 feet away and then tried to track the cue ball 4.5 feet across the table and got not quite there. Got 4 feet,
tell you what,
4 inches.
I think he's got a chance to make the 9 in the side. He kicks it.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to shatter him open. I think he's trying to kick maybe the one for the other side and use the 3 and the 9 as blocker balls.
You're right.
Got it just a little thick, so the cue ball checked up when leaving Dennis a shot.
Oh, that was a very good shot.
Very productive. Dislodged the 2. He could have pocketed the 2, but he could not get the cue ball away from the 7 the other way, so took a chance to maybe develop the 2 enough that he could possibly do something more productive with this inning.
Yeah, he's going to play for the 3 in the side. He's got the angle to do it. Maybe he doesn't think that.
Well, the other thing is to spin it and try to attack the three with the cue ball here. Nope, he's trying to get it. He overcut it.
If it goes, just play position.
So now it looks like his speed control was off, but that was because he overcut the side pocket. He just didn't hit the heart of the pocket as anticipated. He's continuing to look at the three into the side pocket.
Yeah, that's what he's shooting.
Well, he could stop the cue ball there, but he chooses to play offense.
Yeah, he can go one rail to the four. Makes the shot a little tougher.
Looks like he can almost just pin the cue ball to the nine if he wants to play defense.
That's what I said. It made the shot a little tougher. Didn't sell out badly.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he's got here. It looks like he has to play a safety.
Oh, that's all he really has.
But it's not even easy that way. I would maybe think about, I don't think he wants to do it, but try to bank the three over by the eight. That's not what he's doing. He's cutting it the other direction. Your speed control shot.
Yeah, he didn't quite get him.
Did pretty good, but that's
the cut.
Yeah, well, I understand. But look at how it's a naked safety. There's nothing to get behind. It's pure speed control. Real awkward bridge. Cue ball's a diamond and a half off the end rail, and Dennis has got his bridge hand right over the corner pocket.
Yeah, no bargain there.
Now he's moved his bridge hand out onto the table, now back over the pocket. So there's 22 inches of cue out in front of his bridge hand. Looks like he's introducing a little side spin with it, too. What a nice hit.
Yeah, you're right.
Hit the pocket clean.
Awkward bridge, and he made the shot, and he got position. Six passes the eight.
Yeah, it's a matter of getting on it. It's roughly a spot shot here before him. Try to just roll it or two cushion this shot with stun.
Yeah, that will get you closer to the six. That's what he did. He got good. He got the good angle for the seven.
Pretty smooth.
Play the eight and the nine in the same pocket.
Would you call the safety by Han an error? I mean, because Dennis made a nice cut shot and got out, and the safety, there was not much there. It was awkward either way, trying to bank the ball over by the eight.
I wouldn't have played that safe.
Okay, but I'm saying, is that an error?
But it's an error.
Okay, well, he was painted in the corner. It wasn't an egregious error, and the speed wasn't way off.
Oh, I know. O'Collo had to do some great stuff.
Right,
but he did it, so I would say it's an error.
Fair enough. Modern-day official scorers in baseball a lot of times don't call them errors these days. They call them hits compared to when we were kids, you know. And I always kind of wonder about that. But anyway, our official scorer here in the booth said that was an error. So fair enough. There's the rack track. You can see Dennis opened up four in a row. Traded the rack. Cole got two. Dennis got three. Cole got two. Dennis got one. 9-5 is our score. Okay, Dennis is playing the two ball for the side pocket to his right. One ball on the side. Looks like it's going to be a dry break unless the two ball does find it. No, it didn't reach. Got up near it. Dennis is smiling. A little disappointed. Now, the one and the three have lodged up right next to the cue ball, so doesn't look like there's much offensive to do here. It's not fun being behind, and every time you come to the table, you have to play a challenging safety, but that looks like right where we're at.
That's the idea of the game.
So you're just going to bank this out to the middle of the table and put the cue ball down by the five? No, it looks like he's doing something different. Going around the table. Oh,
terrible idea.
The grab on the diamond table rail as he cut across it with the cue ball put a little, introduced what's called hidden English or contact-induced side spin, and that stiffened up the one just enough that it kind of attacked back at the cue ball. Opened everything up, left Dennis straight in on the one.
Well, everything's not quite open. He's got to work it for the seven. Oh, look, he was satisfied to be this far away on the two. No bargains here, pal.
No, he's got some work in front of him. He's carved through a number of these racks already in the set.
Good shot. Nothing easy here. Got to go from the four to the five. That's not going to be a bargain.
No.
Just stop, leave the angle on the four, go two rails to the five. Now he wanted to get closer to him. I don't know what he's going to do here.
No, right. He's going to have to make a big power stroke if he wants to run out.
That's why I would have stopped and just got the angle on the four to go two rails to the five. Now he's got a little more work than that. He's got a little angle here to hit the end rail and go one rail back to the five.
Guess he's going to top spin forward and all the way back down. Big power stroke here.
That's it. No English. It was too tough.
I would love to see the overhead replay again because you could definitely see his cue get quick and see the tip swish left and right. So he was a little bit unsettled on that one. But he didn't leave much.
He didn't leave anything.
Representing Taiwan, Mr. Kevin Chen.
Table number two is the Finnish 10-ball champion sponsored by Texas Pete. Would you welcome Johnny Seeger? And his opponent, Moscone Carpenter.
Good hit. If the cue ball doesn't go in the hole.
Yeah, I remember one time Handsome Danny Jones was playing Grady, and Grady was good and mad at him. And Danny didn't know. And he hit a shot like that, and he goes, I'd hit it, Grady, if I don't scratch.
Well, you know, Handsome Danny Jones wasn't handsome. And Puckett said Danny named himself before Fats could give him a name.
He was a pleasant guy. I always enjoyed him. I wasn't around him that much. He was pretty old, but he was always very cheerful.
Who, Fats?
No, Danny.
Oh, yeah. I knew him very well.
Good decision there. Use the clutter to stop the cue ball next to the six,
yeah,
and open up the seven.
Go two rails, but that'll work.
First time here, Mr. Wilbur Zelinski. On table numbers.
Pretty good. The third rail doesn't count.
No, beautiful. Dennis ORCOLLO.
Hill first.
On the hill.
Yeah, did I hear him mention Earl Strickland? Is Earl here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's playing right now, and he played last night.
He's been playing pretty well.
Here's our Q-Tech stats. 42 balls pocketed, 84 for Dennis. That pretty much sums it up. Dennis has pocketed twice as many balls, and he's won twice as many games. 866, Dennis ORCOLLO. And now he goes back to his preferred side. Waste no time getting down for the shot. Two ball got kissed all around. Didn't make anything, but didn't leave anything. This isn't fun when you're trailing, and every time it's either a safety, yeah, you gotta push out, or now he's looking for the referee. Not sure what that was about. Declare a push out, or push out.
Yeah, he's testing ORCOLLO. He left the edge of the one. I tell you, I gotta shoot this. I don't want to give this back. Too many obstructions.
Yeah, I think he's just going to play the cue ball three rails down underneath the clutter. Yeah. Try to get underneath the two and the three.
Good speed.
Excellent shot.
He had a whole bunch of balls that are cluttered, and he got them. Cole could have done that before ORCOLLO. He pushed. He got the worst of the push.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he hit the ball. Didn't leave much.
Sure, what Dennis is, if he's banking it down by the four, the one ball, or trying to thin the cue ball off the one ball. Almost looks like he's going to follow up with the cue ball into the six. Yeah, trying to introduce the six here. I don't know how much he got him. Looks like he did. So great shot. Not easy to move both those balls that distance, control that well.
Well, everything's a lot easier when you're ahead 10-5.
Now, good executions will get you ahead 10-5 because Ko has played well. And Dennis has made him look a little bit more human just because he's kept the pressure on so constantly.
You mean they let humans in this tournament?
Yeah, we got a pretty dense field of high-quality players. And apparently he hit the one.
And he has a combination if he can hit it. I don't know what he'd gain, but he wasn't playing the combination. Now does the one pass? Well, we'll find out shortly.
Yeah, Dennis seems a little undecided. He might be playing the one solidly into the four and try to drag the cue ball back to the other side of the seven. Oh, but this way. That's a better way.
It's a dirty way, too.
Yeah, good shot. A lot of things going on in that shot. But he took a conservative route.
Well,
he's going to be rewarded here with a... Ko's got to make a two-rail kick.
Look at the position Ko's in. He's losing 10-5. The guy's on the hill, and look what he's got.
Yeah, an awkward kick. For sure.
He's going to kick two rails. A lot of spin. Good hit.
Oh, you got
good
rewarded.
Lead. Look
yeah.
at that.
Beautiful shot. Well done.
Yeah, we got to see that one again. Look at that. Perfect.
All right. Well, that great kick, two-rail kick, has
now,
earned himself a shot.
Is the 2-3 dead in the side? It looks close. If it is, he can go forward and play it.
He's going to do a little inspection.
Well, I don't think he even looked at the combination.
Yeah, he just walked down and looked at it, Danny.
He did?
Yeah.
Well, it either goes or you could throw it and make it.
Well, we'll find out if he liked it or not, because he would definitely opt to play it if he could. So he didn't care for
no,
it.
No, I guess the two passes. Nah, he doesn't have anything.
Yeah, the two goes in.
It does?
He just
it
played for that, yeah.
It passes to three? Thank you.
still a tricky position play to get on the three to get to the four, though. Yep.
Well, you got there. Not easy here.
Mm-mm. No. Yeah, he's looking a couple different routes. Get around the table. No matter what he does, the cue ball will have to come around the table. It plays better if he can go short of the side pocket, but I don't know if he has it. If he can go short of the side pocket with high right, it'll come around nice. Yeah, it does. Perfect route.
Good hit. Well, you know he hasn't given up. Even losing 10-5 and all kinds of crazy stuff, he's not giving up. Got to make the five in the corner and roll a little forward. Got a good chance to get out. Good shot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, smoothly executed. He's got great composure.
Yeah, there's no quitting him.
21 years old.
I don't know about this. Well, he's not snookered. That's all we could say about that shot.
Yes, he can back cut the seven ball. He's looking at it.
Pretty thin hit, Mark.
And then few degrees of elevation.
Good hit. Good hit.
Filter under the rail and make this
tough. Yeah, this isn't real good. This is a little tougher than he wanted.
That was a hard-earned sixth game for Han. Trails in the match 6-10.
Good shooting.
It was. Pretty classy run out.
Yeah, chose no give up.
Sponsor us, always have, always will. Even if you gave me another brand, I would buy Simona's cloth.
Great cloth.
Just because they've always been there, and not only that, it's a great product that performs.
What I like about it, you can shoot soft and cut a ball and it'll move. That other thick stuff, I won't mention names, but this is the best cloth.
Copenhagen breaking now. the two ball to come around to his left. Made a ball.
Yeah, but he didn't get rewarded.
Yeah, boy. Yeah, the cue ball drifts down here. When you play that two ball, it just seems like the cue ball ends up on the end rail a lot.
It does.
Yeah, but last year, Skyler hit his cue ball kind of centering up. So maybe he was using more spin. Likely to see a push out now.
Yeah, but before you push out, cut the three at the
four ball.
Tie a ball up when you push out, because you figure to get the worst of the push. Yeah, push is no good if you don't tie the three up.
Well, yeah, don't visualize Dennis shooting at this. Interesting. Han is going to jump with a near full-length cue. Or is he mad? No, he's jumping. Hit it great. Didn't work out, but he certainly got the cue ball launched a long ways.
Well, I always feel like whoever pushes is going to get the worst of it. That's why I talk about tying the ball up. Yeah. He got pretty good on this. He could stop there. It doesn't matter if he hits Steve. Well, I guess he doesn't have to hit.
Yeah, that was good control there. Now he can kind of manipulate the four ball a little bit with this shot. Didn't even have to touch it.
Got a good angle for the good angle.
It's been a pretty high quality performance by Dennis ORCOLLO. And the statistics will not be over 900. But hard fought, a lot of good decisions. You can definitely see some execution. We're still early stages of the tournament. This is match ball now. And Dennis ORCOLLO will be advancing in the winner's bracket. I believe we're going to have a short interview, so stay tuned, everybody. Rahanna's on the floor. And we're delighted that you joined us today on behalf of Accu-Stats Video Productions. Thank you for joining us again, and so long for just a while.
Hey, this is Rahanna live from the Simonis Aramis Arena, standing here with the undisputed money king, Dennis ORCOLLO. How you feeling, Dennis?
Well, I feel great. I play good, and I have a good start. So I'm glad, you know, I won this day two. So.
That's right, because if you lost to that Cole brother, it would have been a TKO on you, huh? All three of them, right?
Yeah, well, a surprise, you know. I mean, I thought there's only two Cole. Right. But, you know, he's young, and he shoots straight, you know. So, but I just use my experience anyway.
Okay, speaking of your experience, Dennis, are you the undisputed best money player ever? Are you?
No, I don't. I don't. But most of the time, I mean, I won, you know.
Okay, if you're not the best, who was better than you?
I don't know. People say.
He don't want to say it. He want to say he's the king. Dennis ORCOLLO has a big match coming up. You can see him here on Accu-Stats. Do not go anywhere. Dennis ORCOLLO.
Thank you.
I'm going to bet my house on you, bro.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.